Hello viewers, welcome to my channel, Proforma Invoice for Merchandiser. Today our topic is Proforma Invoice or PI. Yes, today's video is very short or small, but the importance of this PI is very much for merchandiser, especially for lingerie merchandiser. Let's look on today's agenda. So I'll discuss the definition of Proforma Invoice or PI, then the uses or importance of Proforma Invoice or PI. Then record information in API or Proforma Invoice. After that, I'll discuss what is the Proforma Invoice and commercial invoice difference. At last, I'll show you some example of Proforma Invoice. So definition, what is the definition? So Proforma Invoice is a preliminary bill of sale sent to buyers from seller in advance of a shipment. Or that when as a buyer, you will place an order to a supplier. So supplier will send one documents mentioning goods description, quantity, price, payment term, shipment method, etc. to buyer to check back that if the order details, price are correct as per the booking or not. Because once the goods will be ready, there might be dispute and it will make a conflict between buyer and seller. So to avoid these types of situation, so PA is supposed to send to buyer to check all details are correct or not. And also, if these are correct, then buyer will send the payment according to this PA. So, uses and importance of Proforma Invoice. First, already I said that it is a document, actually commitment document. It is not the legal documents, but it is a commitment document between seller and buyer. That what order has been placed and what goods will be made. Then this document is required to issue LC or TT by the bank. As I said, that there is no any legal requirement to issue a Proforma Invoice, but this is the general good idea because it allows manufacturers to avoid any disputes at the time of delivery. Also, it serves as import license document, or it is used for arranging the UD to import any goods from other country to Bangladesh or to any other country. It is important as a customs document, customs duty calculation document. Required information in a Proforma Invoice. So PA number and date is important because it will be used for different documents as a unique number. Then applicant's address, beneficiary address, it is required to catch those buyer or seller if any problem happen. Some supplier and buyer, there is a third party like a sourcing officer buyer, which is actually nominated material supplier. In that case, this address is not necessary in that case. But as a document, the address should be there. After that, beneficiary bank details with Swift code, it is mandatory. After that, beneficiary signature and CHOP. CHOP means the sign, approved sign, company seal and sign. After that, goods description. So total goods description, unit price, total value price. This should be there. Now, HS code or Harmonized System Code. It is mandatory to import anything from outside of Bangladesh to Bangladesh. Then GSM width, length, actually the fabric information, if it is fabric. Incoterms. Incoterms is very much important because if it is FOB order or ex work order or CFR or anything, so price will be different and shipment mode will be different. So this Incoterm is mandatory to mention in the PA. Port of shipment or port of destination, port of discharge or port of loading. If it is FOB order, then supplier will send the goods to their port or their country port. But which port it should be, that should be mentioned in the PA. Country of origin. So if it is from China, so country of origin China should be mentioned in the PA. Payment term. So payment term, if it is LC or TT, it should be mentioned in the PA. Mode of shipment. Is it by sea or by air? Or if the quantity is small, it can be courier. So it should be mentioned in PI. Partial shipment allowed or not allowed, it should be mentioned. Then tolerance. It is obvious that what product or goods will be ready. It can be more or less than the order quantity due to the actually wastage thing. So tolerance limit should be mentioned in PI. Normally it is 5% plus or minus, or 3% plus or minus, and possible date of shipment. So this is the thing which is required in Proforma invoice to confirm the delivery date. So when oil supplier will send the PI with this date, if it is okay, then buyer will confirm. Otherwise, you need to negotiate with supplier. What is the difference between Proforma invoice and commercial invoice? Actually, these two documents are almost same, but in commercial invoice, quantity may vary because it will be after goods ready. So there is some tolerance limit. So this quantity may vary actually. Other all information will be same. And second thing is that this is mainly it is used to avoid any conflict or misunderstanding before the shipment, nothing else. And for audit purpose, if any third party audit, so commercial invoice is used, not Proforma invoice. So let's see some example of Proforma invoice. It is a supplier which name is International Motor Limited, and it is their address. Okay, and this one is the PA number, which is the unique number, and this is the PA date, and this is the supplier. This is the buyer actually. This is a buyer who is purchasing from International Molder. Then below here, so for which is tell buyer buying this product, this material. And the material description, what is this material? It's a molded cup. Okay, so this is the molded cup, and here color wise and size wise quantity is mentioned here. This A30, these are the cup size actually, 32A. This one 32A, and this one 34A, in this way. So it looks complicated as it is a cup booking or cup PI. But if it is fabric or elastic, it will be easier, and the color should be correct. Here, this quantity you need to check actually, and as it is a cup, that's why it is paired. You need to check for fabric, elastic. You need to check, is it meter or years? Here you can see it is FOB order, FOB Hong Kong. So price has been set accordingly. If it is CFR, then price will be changed. If this port is different, Shanghai or any other, then price will be changed. So total value you should check before sign back. I'm not discussing other one because all are same, color and size different. So So this is the total quantity and this is the total value you need to check, because you have to pay this amount as it LC or TT. And here there should be mentioned in a word form to avoid any dispute. Here you can see delivery date. So this is the confirmed delivery date. If it is not right, then you need to negotiate. And payment term, LC at site. This is the important thing, the bank details. This is HSBC bank, and this is the account number, a specific account number, supplier account number. And this is the SWIFT code actually. You can see here, I already said. The SWIFT code is important actually to send the payment as a TT. And here you can see the supplier sign and seal. There is a seal actually, but there should be a seal. And here, if all are correct, then you need to sign here and chop your company seal and send back to supplier. And also you need to make payment arrangement. It is another PI, another Proforma invoice. So it is a PI number and PI date is same, not same. For this PI, it is different. and it is actually the supplier is New Horizon, it is their address, and this one the customer or buyer. So you can see here the PO NOM, that is the style number for which style we are buying this product. What is that product? This is the actually elastic. So here I'm not seeing any description actually, but it should be there. Actually I want to say one thing, if it is a lingerie material, sometimes this code is enough, but this should not be, because as a third person I'm not understanding what is the actual product. I know this is elastic PA, but elastic is not mentioned anywhere, so you need to ensure it that there should be the description is correct. Correct means complete. It is incomplete description, only reference is there. So for with the reference you can buy product, there is no problem. And this is a color code should be correct. So quantity should be correct, and this is a unit of meter, and this one is the price unit. Okay, pricing unit 100 meter price. So this price is based on 100 meter, and this is the surcharge, and this is the total value and derivative. So here you can see derivative is in mentioned specifically with the material. If the delivery is different for different quantity, so that's why here you can see, and this is the total value we have to pay as a LC or TT. And here there are terms and conditions mentioned. This is a tolerance, the payment term, and bank details, which is most important. Bank details, SWIFT code. So, and it has a specific one. There is a sign and signature. So thank you for watching, and see you in next video. Please subscribe to my channel and put a like to inspire me. And if you have any comments, so please put in the comment box. Thanks again.